Russian Revolution. Grade 9, Russian Revolution. Now we are going to discuss about Russian Revolution in this video. How the Russian Revolution occurred, what was the impact of this, what are the changes that have come to society after the Russian Revolution. Now, what do we discuss basically in this chapter? We are going to discuss basically about the rebellers, liberals, radicals, conservatives, the industrial society and change, coming of socialism to Europe, Russian Revolution, economy and society, workers, peasants. Then we'll move on to February and October Revolution, First World War and Europe, creation of Duma, Bloody Sunday, 1905 Revolution, the turbulent time and after changes. All these will be covered in this video for you. It's a detailed video and a lengthy video. Please do watch till the end to have complete clarity on this chapter, because we need to cover so many key aspects. That's why it may take a little bit of time for us to complete the entire chapter. That's why the video is lengthy. Welcome to Hamsika Academy. Please subscribe and support and help us to grow more. Socialism in Europe. Let us first try to understand what are the views of the liberals. Liberals wanted a change in the society. Liberals were not democratic. They have toleration towards all religions. Government, they want the governments to be subjected to the laws which are interpreted, which are made and developed by a well-trained, independent judiciary. They want representative elected parliamentary government to rule them. They oppose the controlled, the uncontrolled authority of the dynastic powers, the extensive powers of the dynastic ruler. They want to safeguard the rights of the individual. They do not believe in universal adult franchise and wanted the voting rights only for men who have property. These are the views of the liberals. Liberals wanted a change in the society, the present existing society. We are talking about the early 19th century, early 20th century. A toleration towards all the religions. They want all religions to be respected equally and have tolerance towards each other's religion. A similar secularistic attitude they want. Opposed to the uncontrolled powers of the dynastic rulers. They are completely against the uncontrolled powers of the dynastic rulers of the monarch. They want the rights of the individuals to be safeguarded. And they want the governments to have the laws which are interpreted by well-trained and independent judiciary, so that the king does not influence the judicial department. They want the independent autonomous judiciary to have in place. They want elected representatives to be in the parliament. They were not democratic still, but they want the rights, because they want the rights only for men, not for women who have property. These are the views of liberals. Views of the radicals. Radicals also want change in the society. They want to support women for rights. They oppose the privileges of wealthy landowners and factory owners. They are against the private property, but they oppose the wealth on the concentration of few people only. They believed in majoritarian government approach, which is similar type of democratic government. This is radicals' ideology. They want change. They want to favor women also the rights to vote. They want privileges of the wealthy landowners and factory owners, where the wealth is only in the hands of few people, for which they are against. but they are not against private property. But they want majoritarian type of government. These are the views of radicals. The views of the conservatives. Conservatives, by the word itself, we can understand. They prefer to go with the old pattern, old style, old methodology. They prefer the status quo. They preferred gradual change. They want to bring the old institutions in place. They want the attitude of the people to know and understand them and bring certain gradual change. But their attitude started to change after looking at French Revolution. The changes which have come after French Revolution. So these are the views of conservatives. The views of conservatives are different from the views of radicals. The views of radicals are different from the views of liberals. So we have three groups of people or three sections of people in the society with different ideologies and different views. But everybody wants some sort of change. Maybe it in the slow pace, medium pace, or in the fast pace. But they want change in the existing society. Now, we discussed about the views of liberals, radicals, conservatives. Now, we will discuss about industrial society and social change. Industrial society means industrialization. Due to industrialization, what was the impact on society? Industrialization brought long working hours and the workers are getting poor wages. This is because there are a large number of people working in factories, lot of unemployment, towns, people start to move towards towns from villages, leading to problems of housing and sanitation. Because of industrialization, people started to move. The failure of the crops made them to get and take the jobs in the industries, as many people are intending to work in the industries, which led to job opportunities are less and number of people have an intention to work are more. So the number of people working in the factories are more when compared to the people, those who are willing to work, those who are intending to get a job. That made the industrialists to use this situation and exploit the workers, make them to work for long hours, paying very less wages. If you fight against them or demand any wage, extra pay, they may remove you from job. So, no one dared to question the industrialists or capitalists about the increase of the pay. As they are paid less, and many people are working in factories who are basically not from the cities or towns, they have migrated from nearby villages due to lack of opportunities in the villages. Now, once you move to a town, you don't have a proper house to stay and sanitation facilities, which resulted in more problematic in the society. So, industrial society, due to industrialization, there are few problems also got added to the society of that particular time. Apart from that, the social change, liberals, radicals were the property owners and employers. If freedom of individuals was ensured, if the poor could labor and the other capital would operate without restraint, they believed that the society would develop. They have a different view. That is, the poor could be given equal opportunity to work. Here the problem is there are no such opportunities. The benefit of industrialization should reach to the force that is working for them. They also believed that the healthy and educated citizens would be more productive for the economy. Yes, this point is 100% right. The healthy and the educated citizens would be 100% productive and helpful for the economy. But the point is, we should have basic facilities like housing, sanitation, drinking water, and well in place, then only we can have healthy people. So this resulted in revolutions to end the government of 1815. So when we say here 1815, we need to go back into the pages of history. That is, in 1815, after the defeat of Napoleon Bonaparte, the ruler of France, or the emperor of France to rightly put across, he was defeated in the fourth battle of Waterloo. The battle of Waterloo sealed the fate of the countries which are occupied by France by Napoleon. The Treaty of Vienna was signed in 1815 by England, France, then Germany, Austria and Prussia. Germany was not there, so the Prussia took the place. So these countries divided the other countries which are occupied by Napoleon and forced the French people to agree to this agreement. So then they did not consider any kind of national sentiment. So the people are ruled by foreign rulers or unknown rulers to the people. That is the reason why they want to end the governments which are put in place after 1850. So industrial society and the changes which are intended by the society are these. Now coming to socialism, especially in Europe. By mid-19th century in Europe, socialism was a well-known body of ideas that attracted the widespread attention of public. But what is, first of all, socialism? Socialists were against private property. They saw it as the root cause of all the social ills of the time. Personal gain and not with the welfare of those who made the productive property or property productive. If a society as a whole rather than a single individual controlled the property, more attention would be paid to collective social interest. That's what they felt. They came up with an idea called idea of cooperative. This is the idea of Robert Owen, whose picture you can see on the screen on the right hand side top corner. The leading English manufacturer constructed a community called the cooperative community, which is called New Harmony in Indiana, in United States. This is an individual initiative, what he started. He demanded that the government should encourage more and more cooperatives like this. This is one new ideology which came into existence in the early 20th century. The second key member who played a vital role in the spread of socialism in Europe is Louis Blanc, 1813 to 1882, his lifetime. He wanted the governments to encourage cooperatives and replace the cashless enterprises. He wanted many people to be a part and the ownership, not by the individual capitalist people. Cooperatives were to be associations of people who produced goods, means the working class together, and the dividend of the profits has to be shared by the people, those who had worked for that particular product to become more effective. These are the views of Louis Blanc. Now, we have Karl Marx. Coming of socialism to Europe, Karl Marx is considered as a god for the half of the communist society. He is considered as an evil for the capitalist society, because he always educated that industrial society was capitalist society. Capitalists owned the capital invested in factories, and the profits of the capitalist was produced by workers. He is dead against with the view of the capitalist. He wants the conditions of the workers could not be improved as long as this profit was accumulated by private capitalists. Workers had to overthrow capitalism and rule of private property. He believed that workers should overthrow the capitalists and also the private property concept. He wants workers to fight to free themselves from the clutches of capitalist exploitation. Karl Marx, the author of Das Kapital, is a German philosopher. He has a property. He wants all the properties to be socially controlled, not by individual control, as it is in the capitalist society. Workers would triumph in their conflict with the capitalists. This is the strong belief of Karl Marx, which he educated through number of his books, or let us say series of his books. I have been conducting hundreds of meetings and deliberations, negotiations, conversations with the working class. These are the views of Karl Marx. Next, we have the other influential person, Friedrich Engels. He is also a German philosopher, a communist, social scientist, journalist, businessman. His father was an owner of a large textile factory in Salford, England, and in Bremen, Prussia. Engels developed that what is known as Marxist theory together with Karl Marx in 1845, and he published it. The conditions of the working class in England, based on personal observations and research in English cities. In 1848, Engels co-authored the most famous book, Communist Manifesto, with Karl Marx. These are the contributions of Friedrich Engels. Support for socialism. How did socialism get this support? Initially, there were political parties. The ideology of socialism started to reach Europe by 1870s. There are political parties based on this ideology. Social Democratic Party, SPD. Then 1905, Socialist and Trade Unions formed Labour Party in Britain and Socialist Party in France. Second International. Again, what is Second International? There are three internationals which are conducted, or let us say convened, by Karl Marx. Karl Marx conducted the meetings of all the worker group, trade union group leaders, and all these people. The federations of socialist parties, trade unions, greatly influenced by the ideology, policy, and methods of European labor movement from the last decade of 19th century, conducted the international conferences, which are known as First International, Second International, Third International. So basically, in simple words, we have to say these are the meetings of all the communist party leaders, working parties or worker group associations and trade union group. All these group leaders meetings are called as internationals. The First International, Second International, Third International. Three international meets are organized or convened by Karl Marx. Now, what did they demand in these meetings and all these things? They demanded in the reduction of work time, working hours, the right to vote. They also, workers in England, Germany began forming associations to fight for better living and working conditions. To guide all these people, to support all these people, regularly, every decade, they used to have international meetings conducted by Karl Marx. That's how the support for socialism grew in Europe. Now, moving on to the second part of the chapter, Russian Revolution. Why Russian Revolution only? The Russian Revolution basically deals with the fall of monarchy in February 1917 and the events of October, and normally called the Russian Revolution. Russia is a country which is largely dependent on agriculture, least industrialized nation. After socialist people took over the government in Russia through the October Revolution of 1917, the situation was reversed. Russia, from a least industrialized country, turned to be a most advanced industrialized nation. It became so influential and reached to the position of a superpower, a dominant power in the world. What led the least industrialized country to turn into a most powerful country in the world? We are going to study in Russian Revolution. Russian Empire in 1914. Tsar Nicholas II ruled Russia and its empire. Russian Empire is very vast. It included in the current day Finland, Latvia, Lithuania, Estonia, parts of Poland, Ukraine, Belarus. It also stretched to the Pacific and comprised today Central Asian states, Georgia, Armenia and Azerbaijan. The majority religion was Russian Orthodox Christianity, which had grown out of Greek Orthodox Church, where the empire was also included Catholics, Protestants, Muslims and Buddhists. This is basically the Russian Empire. What is the economy of the Russian Empire and society, how does it? The economy, 85% of the Russian Empire completely depending on agriculture. In France and Germany, the percentages were 40 and 50% respectively. Which means in France it's only 40%. In Germany it's 50%. But in Russia it's 85%. Cultivators produced for the markets as well as for their own needs in Russia. And also Russia was a major exporter of grain. Craftsmen undertook much of the production. Large factories existed alongside craft workshops. Many factories were set up in 1890s while Russia's railway network was extended then. Foreign investment in industry increased only after 1890s. Industries were found only in pockets, only in few areas, only in few corners of the country. Coal production was doubled and iron steel production was quadrupled, four times. What are the changes that are there in the society? What about the workers' conditions? Most of the industries are private properties of capitalists. Women made up of 31% of the factory labor force by 1914, but they were paid very less than men. Workers formed associations to help members in times of unemployment. Divisions among the workers showed themselves in trust and matters too, which means there are divisions among the workers. What are the divisions? The metal workers are considered as the aristocrats of the working class. Why? Because the metal workers need more training and skill. They need to work for nearly 15 hours compared to 10 to 12 hours in the factory hours. The factory inspectors could not prevent when the rules are broken in the factory, because the people in the factories are made to work for 15 hours, which is supposed to be 10 to 12 hours. The government supervision of the factories is to ensure minimum wages and limited hours of work. Government failed drastically because of more number of factories not following the rules, and supervision has become very difficult. Russian economy. In 1902, there occurred a large scale in 1902 in Russia. That is, peasants wanted the land of the nobles to be given to them frequently, and they refused to pay rent, and sometimes they even murdered the landlord. France, KCPC, in France or during the French Revolution. The peasants respected the nobles and fought for them. But the case in Russia is completely different or opposite. Peasants even never refused to murder the landlord. They don't want to pay any kind of tax. Nobles got their power and position through their services to the Tsar and not through local popularity. That's the main reason why the peasants hate the nobles so much. They refuse to pay the taxes so much because it's only to please the Tsar. The nobles used to put pressure on the common people and collect tax. The nobility and the crown, the Orthodox Church, owned the large properties in the country. Peasants cultivated most of these lands and they are asked to pay tax. Frequently, the textile industries in 1896 and 97 and in the metal industry in 1902, there were divisions among the workers. They pooled their lands together periodically and their commune, a mar, is divided it according to the needs of the individual family. That's how they used to do the cultivation. So Russian economy is basically agriculture dominant and there are divisions among the workers. The worker conditions are not good. They had to work for long hours and there was no unity among the peasants and the nobles. Peasants hated the nobles very much because the nobles are getting their position and power only through their services to the Tsars but not by the local popularity. They all used to pool their lands together periodically and commune is divided according to the needs of the individual family. This is, in brief, the Russian economy. Socialism in Russia. All political parties in Russia are declared as illegal till 1914 because till that time the king was not agreeing for parliamentary setup. Social Democratic Workers Party was founded in 1898, who respected Karl Marx's ideas. Because of government policing, it had to operate as an illegal organization. It has set up a newspaper, mobilized workers and organized strikes to maintain its viability and visibility in the society. Russian peasants' customs of dividing land periodically made them naturally socialist and share the commune. There was a new political party known as such Socialist Revolutionary Party formed in 1900 AD. Social Democrats disagreed with socialist revolutionaries about peasants. Lenin felt that peasants were not one united group. That is the reason why we are suppressed by the nobles and the Tsars. Vladimir Lenin thought that in a repressive society like Tsarist Russia, the party should be disciplined and should control the members and the quality of its members. While on the other hand, Mensheviks thought that the party should be open to all and encourage all people to join their party. A turbulent time of 1905. Russia was basically an autocratic country. So Russia is an autocracy. Social Democrats and social revolutionaries, they worked with peasants and workers during the revolution of 1905 to demand a constitution. They want to support in the empire by nationalists in Poland, in instance, and in Muslims, dominated by Zaydis. Who are Zaydis? The Muslim Islamic modernized gurus who want the countries to rule based on the modern ideology of Islam. In 1904, Russia was one of particularly bad year for Russian workers. The real wages decreased by 20%. When four members of the assembly of Russian workers, which has been formed in 1904, were dismissed at Putilo Iron Works, they all called for industrial action, that is strike. They were expecting some thousands of people to come and join the strike. St. Petersburg went on strike with the members of 1,10,000 workers demanding reduction in the working hours to 8 hours. Earlier they were 15, 10 and 12 hours. And the increase in their wages, which got declined by 20%. Improvement in their working conditions, which are deteriorating day by day. These are the demands in 1905. A procession of the workers led by Father Goffin towards the Winter Palace was attacked by the police and the Cossacks. Looking at the crowd coming towards the palace, the police and the Cossacks was afraid that they might be attacking the palace, and they attacked the mob. In this attack, the mob, 100 workers were killed, 300 members were wounded. That's on a sunny Sunday, where it's called as Bloody Sunday, and strikes took all over the country. Universities were closed down. Students' bodies started to stage walkouts. The Constituent Assembly, Tsar allowed for the creation of elected consultative parliament or Duma. Committees and unions worked unofficially since then were declared illegal. Tsar dismissed the first Duma in 75 days and then re-elected the second Duma within 3 months. He changed the voting laws and packed the third Duma with conservative politicians, liberals and revolutionaries were kept out. We have to see the ideology used by the Tsar to put out all the revolutionary leaders out of the parliament. He changed the laws and packed the Duma with only the conservative politicians, means only his favorites. This is how he made Duma, but it is only the people who praised Tsar got place in this. He changed the rules in such a way that liberals and revolutionaries were kept apart. We have to discuss about the Bloody Sunday incident. The Bloody Sunday incident was a very peaceful procession taken by Father Goffin to discuss about the workers' problems and request for help from the king. But it was misunderstood by the police and the officials of the palace. They attacked them and killed them and turned it into a violent Bloody Sunday, which happened on February, the Bloody Sunday day. In some books it's mentioned as January. Some books it's 9th of January. Some books it's 21st of January. Whatever might be the date, but there was a huge loss in the working community. A peaceful procession has been attacked. Scared with the moments and consequences, king allowed for the creation of Duma, but he cancelled it within 75 days, dismissed it. Then, the re-elected second Duma within 3 months, because he is scared that people would revolt. Third time, when there is a Duma, he brought new laws in place, making it very clear that the liberals and revolutions will never enter the Duma in this process. So, making them naturally ineligible to that posts and positions. This triggered the anger of people more. So now what is the condition of Russia in 1914? In 1914, the First World War broke out between two European allies, the Allied powers versus the Axis powers. The First World War on the Eastern Front is different from the Western Front. It is on the Eastern border, is different from the Western border. Armies fought from trenches stretched along the eastern front. What is a trench? A trench is a wall built by digging a land little bit. The soldiers will be inside the land, in the land wall, the wall. Beside that, there is a land which is dipped inside. Soldiers can hide themselves. And these trenches are filled with rainwater sometimes with rats, sometimes with small snakes, all these things. But still, they have to stay their role in the trench. 3 million refugees in Russia added to this. While on the eastern side, the armies have to move to a great deal. They have to run and fight the battles, leaving large number of casualties, because there you have to fight openly. The opponent can see your moves and attack you. Well, when you are in a trench, you can hide yourself, but in the open area you can't hide. Fighting on the eastern side. Well, on the western side we have trenches. There are over 7 million casualties by 1970. Russian army destroyed crops and buildings, realizing that if we lose the war, we have to prevent our enemies being able to live off the land. So if you destroy our own crops, enemy will not find any food here. Then he will not be able to survive much. The World War I initially gave very good popularity for Tsar, because he was rallying with the praising people for him in the Duma. Tsar refused to consult even the main political parties in Duma, and he blindly followed the advice of Tsarina Alexandria's German origin and Rasputin the monk. So Tsar's wife Tsarina Alexandria is basically a German. She wants the Saint Petersburg name to be changed as Petrograd, which is the German origin name. Soldiers would not fight in such a war conditions, and people got angry when the names were changed from the original Russian origin to German origin, only on the advice of the monk, that is Rasputin, because to please the princess, which is really a very bad. World War I and the effects in Russia. The labor shortage, small workshops producing essentials were shut down because there is no labor to work. War also had severe impact on industry. Large supplies of origin, the grains, were sent to feed the army. Riots broke out near the bread shops because people are not getting sufficient food. Failure of the crops. Country was completely cut off from the suppliers of industrial goods by the German control of Baltic Sea. Germans have took over the control of the Baltic Sea and cut off the supplies which are entering into Russia. By 1916, railway lines start to be break down due to the war attacks. These are the World War I's effects: labor shortage, large supply of food to the army, no food for common people, riots broke down for the workers, severe impacts on the industry. Country was cut off from the supplies of the industrial goods because Germany took over the control of the Baltic Sea. And by 1916, railway lines began to break down because of the impact of World War I. Moving on to February Revolution in Petrograd. The layout of the city seemed to emphasize the divisions among the people in the society during that particular point of time. The workers' quarters and factories were located on the right banks of the river Neva, while the left bank was fashionable area with the Winter Palace, official buildings, including the palace where the Duma met. February 1917 was a time when workers were experiencing extreme food shortage in everywhere in the workers' quarters. Parliamentarians are wishing to preserve elected government, were opposed the Tsar's desire to dissolve the Duma. Winters were very cold and there had been exceptional frost and heavy snow. Women led the way to strike. This came to be called the International Women's Day. 22nd of February, a lockout took place in the factory on the right bank. No political parties was actively organized the movement. This was the situation in February 1970. The fashionable quarters and official buildings were surrounded by workers. The government imposed curfew. Politicians spoke against the measures. Demonstrators dispersed by the evening. The cavalry and the police were asked to keep an eye on them. On Sunday, 25th of February, the government suspended the Duma. Politicians now got frustrated and angered and want to participate against the measures of the government with the public support. On 27th, police headquarters were ransacked. People started raising slogans against bread, wages, better hours, and democratic setup. An officer was shot at the barracks of the regiment, and three other regiments mutinied, voting to join the striking workers. Soldiers, the striking workers, had gathered to form a Soviet or a council in the same building as the Duma met, and this meeting is called as Petrograd Soviet. Tsar's abdication. Tsar followed the advice of the Soviet. The Soviet leaders, the Duma leaders, formed a provincial government to run the country. A delegation went to see Tsar with the military advisors and advised him to abdicate the throne. As there are no options left, he followed the advice and abdicated on 2nd of March. Russia's future would be decided by the Constituent Assembly based on universal adult franchise or suffrage election. Petrograd had led the February Revolution that brought down the monarchy in March 1917, popularly known as February Revolution of 1917. After February, what changes have occurred? Army officials, landowners, and industrialists grew very influential in the provincial government. There were restrictions on public associations and meetings during Tsar's rule, which were removed completely. Bolshevik Party renamed itself as the Communist Party. Lenin and the Bolsheviks had opposed the war since 1940. Vladimir Lenin, the leader of the Bolshevik group, returned to Russia from exile after 1905. In 1917, hearing to the news of abdication of Tsar from throne, he proposed April thesis. He declared the war to be brought to a close, land to be transferred to the peasants, banks to be nationalized. People are initially surprised with his agendas. In the subsequent months, people's attitudes changed in favor to Bolsheviks party. What happened next? Government measures. Factory committees were formed, which began questioning the way industrialists ran their factories. Trade unions grew in number. Soldiers' committees were formed in the army. Workers resisted to run factories and began arresting leaders. Workers who resisted the running of factories on the guidelines given by the Lenins, because they want sufficient working hours, reducing the working hours timing, they are being arrested. Government decided to take steam steps. Looking at the growing popularity of Bolsheviks, they want to suppress the Bolsheviks movement. They want to suppress the worker leaders. The news in June that there were 500 Soviet groups were sent to represent all Russian Congress of Soviet, with which the government is very clear that The influence of Bolsheviks started to grow. The government's influence started to reduce. The government is run by Mensheviks. Joseph Kerensky is the prime minister of the provincial government. He understood that he has to take certain strong steps to control the growth of Bolsheviks' influence. Whenever we try to restrict something, it bounces back with huge energy. The same thing happened here also. The conflict. The provincial government and the Bolshevik government, Bolshevik party's strength started to grow. Now, looking at the steps taken by the government, Lenin got scared and feared that the government would set up a dictatorship. 16th October 1917, Bolshevik supporters in the army, Soviets and factories were brought together. They agreed to socialist seizure of power, take the power into their control on the date of 16th October 1917. Military Revolutionary Committee was appointed under the leadership of Leon Trotsky to organize the seizure of political power. Now, looking to this news, this revolution is called October Revolution. The uprising began on 24th October. Prime Minister Kerensky had left the city to call and summon the troops, to order the troops. Military men, those were loyal to the government, seized two Bolshevik newspapers. Hearing to this news, telephone and telegraph offices and protect the Winter Palace, the army is summoned. Military Revolutionary Committee under the leadership of Leon Trotsky, which comprised of army, Soviet and factories, brought together, ordered to seize the power of government offices and arrest it. A ship named Aurora sailed down to the Winter Palace. City was under committee's control and the ministers had to surrender. The majority approved the Bolshevik action. Heavy fighting, especially in Moscow, but could not sustain. What was the result of October Revolution? What changed after October? Many industries and banks were nationalized in November 1917. They banned the use of old titles of aristocracy. Government took over the ownership and management of factories. New uniforms were designed for army and officials. Land was declared social property and peasants were allowed to seize the land from the nobility. The Soviet new cap for the army officials, Budzinovka, was chosen. Bolsheviks enforced the partition of large houses according to the family requirement. Bolshevik party is renamed as Russian Communist Party. Bolsheviks conducted the elections to the Constituent Assembly, but they failed to gain the majority support. Assembly rejected Bolsheviks' measures and Lenin dismissed the assembly. Assembly rejected Bolsheviks' measures. Lenin got angry and Lenin dismissed the assembly. Despite of opposition by other political allies, Bolsheviks made peace with Germany at Brest-Litovsk to end the World War I, which is one of the promises made by Lenin in April thesis. After October, what happened? Civil war broke out. Bolsheviks became the only party to participate in the elections to All Russian Congress of Soviet, which became the parliament of the country. Russia became a one-party state. A secret police force called Cheka, later named as OGPU and NKVD, punished those who ever criticized the Bolsheviks. The young writers and the artists rallied to the party because it stood for some change in the society. Many became disillusionized because the censorship the party encouraged. Bolsheviks ordered land redistribution. Russian army began to break up. Once the land order of redistribution is issued, the army soldiers want to go back because peasants wish to go home, and the redistribution of the land and deserted the army, which resulted in civil war. What happened in the civil war? Bolsheviks, referred as the Reds, versus the Greens, the Socialist Revolutionaries, the Whites, the pro-Tsarists, controlled most of the Russian Empire. Bolsheviks fought a civil war, but it resulted in looting, banditry, and famine became common in the country. Whites took harsh steps towards the peasants who tried to seize the land. Those who are supporters of Tsars, who took harsh steps by killing the people whoever tried to seize the land. January 1920, the Bolsheviks controlled most of the former Russian Empire. They received cooperation from non-Russian nationalities and Muslim Jadidists, modernized Islamic followers. They received non-cooperation from Russian colonists who were against Bolsheviks. Bolsheviks also used brutally massacred measures to kill the local nationalists on the name of defending socialism. People were in confused state whether to follow the Tsarist followers or the Bolshevik followers. Either you follow the Bolsheviks' measures, you will be killed by Tsarists. If you don't follow them, you will be killed by Bolshevik followers. What to do next? Because basically, the anti-Bolshevik group, the Greens and the Whites, are backed by French, American, British, and the Japanese troops. All those forces were worried at the growth of socialism in Russia and also looking their future. It might affect them. So they want to destroy it in Russia itself. That's why they cooperated for revolt against Bolshevik. What happened next? Socialist society. Most non-Russian nationalities were given political autonomy in Soviet Union, resulting in the formation of Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. Bolsheviks created from Russian Empire in December 1922. Harsh disencouragement for nomadism has been encouraged. You have to settle at a place and do farming there. Attempts to win over the different nationalities was only partly successful because it's not completely successful. You can never be successful in winning the support because there they are basically against the Bolsheviks. Industries and banks were nationalized. They want to cultivate the land that had been socialized. Centralized planning was introduced. Officials assessed how the economy could work and set targets for 5-year period. They promoted industrial growth during the 2 5-year plans. First 2 5-year plans. The 5-year plan's concept has been basically the centralized planning led to the economic growth. Industrial production increased drastically. Industries and workers. What was the condition of industries and workers? New factory cities came into being. Rapid construction led to poor working conditions. Construction of a steel plant was done just in 3 years, city of Magnitogorsk. That resulted in the stoppage of 550 stoppages of work in first year alone, but still they're able to manage it. Means the worker conditions are not good. In the winter time, at 40 degrees below the temperature, people had to climb down the 4 floors and dash across the street in order to go to toilet. This is the condition of the world. Extended schooling system was developed. Arrangements were made for the factory workers and peasants to enter into university. Crèches were established in factories for the children of women workers. Cheap public health care was provided. Since government resources were limited, all these are not available to all sections of society. Stalinism and collectivization. What is Stalinism and collectivization? Stalin emerged as the leader of USSR after the demise of Lenin. He wanted to have a planned economy, like the disaster of collectivization of agriculture. He wanted to reduce that. He believed that shortage was only due to small size of holding. Due to the shortage of food grains, the decision was taken to cultivate collectively the farming. In 1928, party members stood the grain producing areas and supervising the enforced grain collection and raiding the kulak. He believed that the rich peasants and traders in the countryside are doing this. So he introduced firm emergency measures. Peasants refused to sell, strict actions were taken. Government fixed the prices. Peasants have to sell at the same price. Soviet Russia was facing an acute problem of grain supply. That's why government fixed the prices. Refused to sell by the peasants. Firm measures were taken by the government. The rich peasants and the traders in the countryside resisted. In 1928, party members stood the grain producing areas, supervised the enforced grain collections and raided the kulaks. In this way, he wanted to reduce the shortage of grain and continuous supply of grain. But is Lenin successful in this, or is Stalin successful in this? Lenin was successful, but Stalin has to face little bit of resistance from the common people. In 1939, there are over 2 million people who were as prisoners in the labor camps. His sympathizers charged the critics with conspiracy against socialism. He eliminated the kulak, the storehouses of the rich. Party forced all peasants to cultivate in collective farms. Peasants worked on the lands and the kolkhoz profits were shared. Collective farming. Enraged peasants resisted. The authorities destroyed their livestock. Many were deported or exiled. Some independent cultivation existed, but such cultivators are treated unsympathetically. Production did not increase. In fact, of all these measures taken due to the bad harvest in 1933, led to most devastating famine in Soviet history, when over 4 million people died. There were severe criticisms about the confusion of collectivism of Stalin. His sympathizers were charged the critics for saying that it's a conspiracy against socialism, and nearly 2 million people were tortured and killed in the labor camp by 1939. What happened? Global influence of the Russian Revolution and USSR. The possibility of the workers' state fired people's imaginations across the world. A backward country became a great power. Many non-Russians from outside USSR participated in the conferences of people of the East in 1920. The Bolshevik founded Comintern. The USSR had given socialism a global face and a world stage. Industries and agriculture had developed, but it had denied the essential freedom to its citizens and carried out its developmental projects through repressive policy. The international reputation of the USSR. The ideas of socialism were rethought. By 1950s, the style of government in the USSR was not in keeping with the ideas of Russian Revolution. this is the global influence of Russian Revolution and US. Thank you very much for watching Hamsika Academy. Please subscribe and support us. Please do comment below if you need anything. We'll try our level best to make much better video as per your expectations. Please share it and subscribe. Thank you.